In just a wee while, Google should be launching its new Nexus phones, dubbed the Marlin and the Sailfish, which means that hopefully last year's models, the 5X and the 6P, will plummet in price. The Nexus 5X was the cheaper of last year's Google blowers, despite sharing many of the same features with the more expensive Nexus 6P. But despite that, we still only gave it 4 out of 5 stars at the time. So, is it worth a purchase if you spy it now for cheap? Well, the 5X's looks certainly haven't improved with age. It's definitely the ugly sibling of last year's Nexus phones, sporting a rather generic plastic frame that pales in comparison to the metal jacket of the 6P, as well as similarly priced rivals like the OnePlus 3. That said, our white model, or Quartz to give it its proper wanky moniker, does at least stand out a bit from the crowd, even if it lacks the premium finish of rivals. And after many months of fondling with greasy, sweaty fingers, plus the occasional bump and scrape, the 5X is still in good nick too. It's obviously quite a tough little bugger and very light as well compared with most other mid-range mobiles. The 5X's rear-mounted fingerprint scanner sits naturally beneath the index finger when you grab the phone, so you can unlock the Nexus quickly and securely when needed. It's still pretty fast as well, beaten only by the latest rivals such as the OnePlus 3, and it's usually really accurate, only really struggling when you've got damp digits. One of my biggest complaints with the Nexus 5X is the fact that there's no support for microSD memory cards, and you only get a choice between 16 and 32 gigabyte flavors. This means you'll need to learn to love the cloud if you regularly take lots of snaps or watch a lot of video on the move. Still, I don't have any complaints with the 5X's 5.2-inch IPS LCD display. That full HD resolution keeps everything crisp and clear, complete with natural colors and deep blacks. Although rivals like the Galaxy A5 and the OnePlus 3 do boast richer, more vibrant hues. As this is a Google-branded phone, the Nexus 5X was of course the first mobile to rock Android 6.0 Marshmallow, along with the Nexus 6P. It's a vanilla version of Google's OS with no modified launcher or feature-packed overlay, so you really do get a straightforward and pleasingly clean user experience. And you can of course expect the Nexus 5X to get an update to Android Nougat as soon as the new Nexus phones launch, well ahead of rivals, although the likes of the Moto G4 and the G4 Play probably won't be far behind. The 5X's Snapdragon 808 processor is definitely getting a bit creaky these days. Performance on the whole hasn't been bad over the past year, but I do notice the occasional stutter or pause. For instance, loading up an app sometimes takes a few seconds, which is particularly annoying when it's the camera app and you've only got a limited time to capture your shot. I've also noticed a couple of random little crashes, such as the Photos app locking up when I attempted to delete a photo. And the Nexus 5X does get a little toasty at times too, especially when using that camera. We're not exactly talking about liquid hot magma levels, but sometimes it can be a wee bit unsettling. As for battery life, the Nexus 5X will just about make it through a full 24 hours these days, as long as you don't hammer it. But if you're constantly whipping out the phone to take snaps, for instance, then it will definitely die a lot sooner. And again, compared with phones like the OnePlus 3 and the Moto G4 Plus, that's a poor result. There's no support for wireless charging either, but that's not exactly something that I've missed. And while the fast charge feature isn't exactly a match for the likes of OnePlus's dash charge feature, at least it means you get a full charge in roughly an hour and a half. My favourite bit of the Nexus 5X is still that 12.3 megapixel camera, which produces sharp, realistic images in everything but dim light. It's pretty much the same snapper as the more expensive Nexus 6Ps, although you don't get a couple of that phone's features such as the 240 frames per second slow motion video capture. You do, however, get full 4K recording, something that many rivals miss out on. And the 5X definitely holds up well against its rivals when it comes to photography, thanks to the dependable HDR feature which pisses all over tricky lighting conditions. Check out our full 5X camera review for samples and more. Since the Nexus 5X hit UK stores, loads of similarly priced rivals have also been released, such as the Moto G4 Plus, the OnePlus 3 and the Samsung Galaxy A5 2016. And even if the 5X does drop in price, it's difficult to recommend thanks to those performance issues and poor battery life. If you can't afford the excellent Nexus 6P, or don't fancy such a whopping big handset, then definitely check out one of those rival phones instead. For the full long-term Nexus 5X 2016 re-review, check out recombo.com/mobile, and don't forget to subscribe to the Recombo YouTube channel. Thanks for watching.